as a factual matter, the United States, those of you who worry about an American invasion in any of your countries should sleep well, because right now the United States, both the Democrats and the Republicans, are isolationist. I'm sorry?
Are using drones. They don't send their people anymore.
Well, I am not. You know, hold on. Are you a pacifist?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not. And many people are not. And there are good moral reasons not to be a pacifist. We can disagree about that. But the fact that the United States uses drones, from the standpoint of the morality of war, perhaps you think war has no morality, but we know that philosophically and theologically, there is such a thing as a just war, and people in this continent are living off the fruits of a just war.
Was Vietnam a just
war? No, of course not. No.
Was
no.
Iraq a just war?
No, it was not. World War II, certainly. I prayed every night that the United States would send 5,000 troops into Syria in 2012 and 13 and 14 to stop that madman from systematic rape and genocide and the murder of children. And in 1972, George McGovern, the greatest dove who ever lived, suggested that an international force be raised to stop Pol Pot's genocide in Cambodia. There are moral emergencies. There are madmen with power in this world who are prepared to do repulsive things to men, women, and children. And we can either decide that we have no right to intervene or violate their sovereignty, or that we are pacifists, in which case we may as well concede that we are prepared to see these evils proceed without any obstacle. But if we agree that we are not prepared to see them proceed without any obstacle, then we are back in the discussion of who uses what kind of force when. And that is a very, very fundamental thing. There is evil in the world.
Do you understand who created ISIS or who sustained it?
Oh, I have a different... I understand how you understand who created ISIS. Yeah. But I think it's a much more complicated picture than that. I do not believe that everything that anybody in the world does is either a direct or indirect response to the United States. I think that people in South Asia and in the Middle East have agency and cultures and traditions and interests, and I think they act upon their own perceptions and representations of their situation. It is a very complicated world. It really is not the case that directly or indirectly, everything bad that happens can be traced back to the Pentagon.